Hi everybody, it's Guy Yelso here. In the world of classic rock, one of my all-time favorite drummers is Ian Paice of Deep Purple. I love this guy. And what better song to show off his incredible playing than the song Burn? I'm going to do a timeline breakdown of the song coming up right now. Also, please like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel, and thank you in advance. So, here we go. The mighty Deep Purple, one of the unholy trinity of British hard rock bands, along with Led Zeppelin and Black Sabbath. Now, Deep Purple has gone through so many personnel changes over the years, their history is labeled Mark 1, 2, 3, and through it all, Ian Paice is the only member that's been there from the very beginning in 1968. And the first thing that comes to mind when you say Ian Paice to other drummers is the hands. His speed and control is amazing. His sound is his own, and I put him right up there with the greatest of the British rock drummers like John Bonham and Keith Moon. The 1974 song Burn was both the opening track and title song from the Mark III version of the band, and it was the first album to feature David Coverdale on vocals and Glenn Hughes on bass. It's in 4/4, fast as hell at 196 beats a minute. It's 6 minutes long and has 24 part changes. The timeline begins with a long intro, and this intro has three forms, and it confuses the hell out of me trying to remember which one comes next. You have a 16-bar long version, a short 8-bar version, and also a short 4-bar version, only between the two verse cycles. Count off and crash on one, some hits on bar four, and drums enter with a fill at 10 seconds to bar eight. A pattern is a 2-bar phrase. Next, at 21 seconds, starts the famous verse cycle with Ian Paice playing these fantastic fast fills over the singing. There's always two verses with a short intro in between that leads to a chorus. Paice plays a freeform concept of fast accented notes, mainly on the snare, filling in around the singing and some kicks with the band. The concept is what's important, not playing what's on the record. I'm not going to, and Ian Paice never does. He changes it up all the time. The concept of filling around the singing is what's important here. Play what you feel, even if it's just keeping time in the verses. Now, we're in between the two verses on that 4-bar intro. The second verse of the cycle is at 36 seconds. It ends with a snare roll to 1 and breaks before the chorus at 47 seconds. Chorus is just a 1-bar phrase. Okay, now this whole intro verse, chorus cycle repeats again, and then it goes to a short 8-bar intro at 137 to a bridge at 147. Bridge has these upbeats that you accent with the band. At 206 is another short 8-bar intro to the two main solo sections starting at 216. First, it's guitar. Second, it's keyboards with a long intro and a bridge in between. The solos are like a symphonic suite in three parts and very, very long at 48 bars each. For that reason, I'm going to play a condensed version of the guitar solo. Now, Paice keeps it straight and simple, just 2 and 4. The first part, the bass drum is reacting to what he hears. The second part, he tightens it up to a 1-bar pattern. A third part ends the solo section with a fast band break together. After both solos at 4:45, we come back to the form from the beginning of the song, intro, verse, chorus cycle. It goes to one final short 8-bar intro at 5:32 to a new end section at 5:42 with down and upbeats to a big trash can ending. Amazing song. They don't write them like that anymore. Deep Purple at its best. Not an easy song to play, mainly because of the tempo, but find your own way to play fills in the verses, and the rest is pretty straight ahead. Ian Paice is a beast on drums. He always plays it solid for the song, but at any time, he can turn it around and pull out fireworks. He's been a major influence on myself and many, many drummers that came after him. So I hope you guys enjoyed it, and don't forget, practice hard, keep it simple. Till the next time. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. And if you're new to my channel, ring the bell so you know when I post new videos, which I try to do every week. Give it a thumbs up and comment. That's very important to me. I love to hear your feedback. Follow me on Instagram at Guy Gelso, and also don't forget to check out GuyGelso.com. There you can enter your email for any new events and shows I'm doing, and to get in touch with me for private lessons. Thanks for watching, practice hard, and keep it simple.